gentlemen, this is a bobsled.
The classic movie Cool Runnings will be our starting point, but today we're using various clips to discuss three ways on how to achieve your goals no matter what, and stay tuned to the end because we will be discussing a syndrome that is made up but I'm almost certain you have and how you need to overcome it. Let's start with the first idea now. One reason why we don't achieve our goals is because we're like this character here, Sanka.
Sanka, I know, I'm the driver, right?
No, you're the brake man.
No, I'm the driver.
No, you're not. You're the brake man.
I'm the driver.
You're not. You're the brake man.
You don't understand. I'm Sanka Coffee. I'm the best pushcar driver in all of Jamaica.
He wants to be the driver, the most glamorous position, but see why he's not qualified for the job.
You see, Sanka, the driver has to work harder than anyone. He's the first to show up and the last to leave. When his teammates are all out drinking beer, he's up in his room studying pictures of turns.
You see his face here? All of a sudden he doesn't want to be the driver. And that's why we don't achieve our goals. We often fixate on the glamorous parts of the position or the goals that we achieve, but we fail to realize the discipline and the sacrifice involved.
You see, a driver must remain focused 100% at all times. Not only is he responsible for knowing every inch of every course he races, he's also responsible for the lives of the other three people in his sled.
If we want to achieve our goals, we have to respond to the sacrifices, the discipline, and responsibility the way his teammate, Derrice, does.
Now, do you want that responsibility?
I say we make Derrice the driver.
So do I, Sanka. So do I.
Oh, the back is nice.
And just because you say no to the responsibility, the discipline, and the sacrifice of one position doesn't mean that you're a failure or a lazy. It could just mean that you're meant to do something else, that you're meant to have another position. Bottom line, to achieve anything great, it's going to take some sacrifice. Before you set this big goal, assess what you're giving up. Are you willing to come in early? Are you willing to stay in late? Are you willing to stay in your room working when your friends are having fun? This is something to consider before starting a goal. Okay, number two is the Chameleon Challenge, and let's watch this awesome clip that I got from this channel, Zooming Tube. For this message to make sense, you have to stick with me, but notice as the chameleon walked through the blue platform, it changes color. Okay, now the chameleon is going to walk across a red platform. Can you guess what will happen? You see, I believe in order to give yourself the best chance of being successful in life, you can't be like this chameleon. This chameleon is subject to change its color based on its environment, based on the platform that it walks on. You could very well answer that calling you have to be a driver in your own sense, just like Derrice, but a lot of people don't succeed because they change their color based on how they feel. They may also change their color to appease the people around them, to be accepted, to fit in, to feel normal. One of the toughest things in life is the Chameleon Challenge. One, that's figuring out what your purpose in life is and what you need to do, and two, staying true to it, not changing your color based on how you feel and the people around you. Okay, now for the made-up syndrome I discussed earlier, Popeye syndrome. When you think of Popeye the Sailor Man, I'm sure you think of spinach. He would eat it to become strong, but I think of this quote that he made repeatedly. I am what I am, and that's all that I am. This is Popeye syndrome right here, and this is why so many people are hopeless and depressed. They don't like where they are, and they believe they're stuck. There's nothing they could do about it. But that's foolish. Too many times I hear people discuss what they are and what they're not, and it defines their identity. For example, I'm not good with people. Well, you also don't talk much. If you talk more, you'll get better. You'll get more confident, and you'll be better at talking. I'm not good with computers. Well, if you spent more time on the computer and you got coaching and you developed that skill set, you would get better with computers over time. Just about any skill in your life can be developed, and to believe that where you are is where you're going to be the rest of your life is a hopeless mindset. There you have it, three ideas on how to achieve your goals in life. Let's do a quick recap. Number one, don't be like Sanka. Before you agree to a goal, assess the responsibility and sacrifice involved before you take it on. Number two, the Chameleon Challenge. If this goal is in alignment with your true self, your true color, don't change based on your emotions or the response of people around you. And number three, overcome Popeye syndrome. As I mentioned, it's a made-up syndrome. You may be who you are right now, but that's not all you're going to be. There's an other side to you that you don't even realize. If you're wondering what that other side is, subscribe to my channel today because I have a book coming out soon called The Other Side of Life where you'll gain a positive perspective and see life more clearly. The videos are in alignment with that book. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope they help you achieve your goals in life, and I cannot wait to see you in the next video.